Today you're going to learn how you can switch between charts with a radio button in Excel. And this is an easy trick that you can use when you're setting up interactive dashboards. Okay, so I have the sales data for different apps by division. I want to create radio buttons for the division. This way I can control what sales data shows up in the chart. Now, as you can see, my source data is unfortunately messy. Before I create the chart, I need to clean up the data that I want in the chart. I don't want to change my source. I just want to add an in-between table that gets the job done. This is going to be my data prep. But before I get my hands dirty, let's add our radio buttons. To do that, you need the developer tab. So if you don't see this developer tab, you can easily add it to your ribbon. Just right mouse click, go to customize the ribbon, place a check mark beside developer, and then click on OK. Then you're going to see this, and then you can go ahead and insert your radio buttons, which you can do from insert controls under form controls. Here is the radio button or the option button. Now just click on it and then draw it out here. Click inside and let's overwrite this. So instead of option button one, I want to have game here. So this is one of the divisions that I have. Then I want to add two more option buttons, one for utility, another for productivity. So here I can hold down control. So I'm going to click on this, hold down control, and then drag this to the side. That's going to create a second copy and now a third copy. Okay, so select the second one. You can also right mouse click and edit text if that's easier. Then let's go with productivity. And last one is utility. Okay, so I have these set up and let's just arrange them wherever we want to have them in our report. Now, what happens when I click on one? I get this black dot in the middle. And notice that it's smart. It knows that they belong together. I can't select two of these at the same time. Now, the reason it thinks that they belong together is because I don't have them inside a group. So whenever I add another option button to this sheet, it's automatically going to belong to this set. If I want to create different sets of option buttons, I need to put them inside a grouping. That looks like this. So that's a group box. If you click it, drag it out here, and carefully place your option buttons in a group box, then they're going to be independent to other option buttons that you might have on that sheet. Now, in this case, I don't need this grouping because these are going to be the only option buttons I have on this sheet. Now, after I add these, the next step is to select one of them, right mouse click, go to format control, and add a cell link to it. This way we know what option button has been selected. So where are we going to put this cell link? Let's put it in cell F1. So for cell link here, I'm just going to go and click on F1. That's going to put the result of this option button. The result is whatever is selected. So notice when I'm on game, we see one. When I'm on productivity, we see two. I'm just going to bring this to this side here so that we can easily see what's selected. Then when I click on utility, we see three. Now, how did it add a cell link to these when I only added it to game? Well, because they automatically belong together, if you right mouse click on any other one, go to format control, you're going to see F1 in the other ones as well, right? So this was automatically added when we added the cell link to one of these option buttons. That saves us the work of having to do this for each of these. Okay, so far so good. Next step in the process is to grab the data that I need. So if someone selects game, I need the app and sales of the game division here. How do I do that? I can use the filter function. Let's add the headers here. So I want app and I want sales. Now right here, we're going to start off with filter. This is a function in Office 365. It needs an array. The array is the result that I want to get back. In this case, I want the app column and the sales column, so I'm going to select those. The include argument is what I want to have included. This is similar to the logical test that you do in the if statement, except that we can reference an entire column and not just a single cell. So here I want to check whether division equals the division that's selected here. Now, what's the problem? Well, division here is reflected as a number. Because game was the first option button that I inserted, it gets a value of 1. When I select productivity, it was the second option button, it gets a 2. I need to somehow translate these numbers into the divisions. So if it's 1, I want game. There are different ways you can do this. One function that I haven't yet covered on the channel is the switch function. So that's the one that we're going to use in this case. This function is really easy to use. You can tell it to switch one value for another value. All you need is an expression. This is F1. This cell has the value that I want to switch. Next is the value itself. So if it's a 1, what do I want? I want the result to be game. If it's 2, I want it to be productivity. And if it's 3, I want it to be utility. I'm not sure if I spelled everything correctly. We're going to see in a second if the formula works correctly or not. So I'm going to close the bracket for switch, close it again for filter, press enter, and this works. This is Arcade. It's the first game app. Then I have the Rambler, Fighter, and so on. And when I switch to productivity, I get the app and sales for the productivity division and utility. Okay, so far so good. Let's also add some number formatting to this. It works great. So if I wanted a dynamic table, I'd already have one. But I want to go beyond this. I want to add a chart. Let's highlight the range. So I'm going to include the headers here. Go to insert, and let's insert a bar chart. Right here, we have a 2D bar. Okay, so I'm going to place it right here. Let's organize these a bit better. Just holding down Control, selecting these, and let's bring them a bit over so it's above my chart. Let's quickly adjust some settings. I'm going to remove the labels here, right mouse click on the data bars, and add the data labels to these. Okay, let's also remove the grid lines. Okay, so far so good. What do we have here? We have Twister showing up first, then Perino, Cryptis, Fighter, and so on. Now, it would be nice if we could automatically sort this. That's easy to do because we can use the sort function here. Right after the equals, we're going to add a sort. The array is the result that we have from filter, which is all of this. And then we can specify which column we want to sort. This is the first column and then the second column, so that's easy. I'm going to go with the second column. And then we can decide if I want it in ascending and descending order. Now notice, because Excel shows the last app here first, I want to go in this case with ascending. So with a 1, close bracket, press enter, and now we get everything properly sorted, right? Because the biggest one is going to end up last here, which is going to show up first in the chart. Okay, so this looks great. Now let's switch to productivity. That's good. And utility. It looks like we have a problem here. Utility has less apps than game. So we get a gap right here. And actually, productivity has more apps than games. So we are missing something. We are missing that last app here. If your data has the same number of categories, you don't have to do anything, right? You'd be done right now at this point. But because we have this issue of varying number of categories, we need to take this a step further. We need to make our chart smarter so it can detect the range it needs to plot. Now, chart ranges, unfortunately, can't take direct formulas. They can only take cell references. So if we right mouse click, go to select data, this is our sales value. So if I go to edit, we can see the series values are these. This is a direct cell reference. I cannot add a formula here, or I can't use hash to get dynamic ranges. Instead, I need to use the name manager to create a dynamic range. And then here I can use the name. So I know it sounds a bit complex, but it's actually quite easy to set up. We're just going to go to name manager. So let's go to formulas, name manager. Right here, we're going to add a new name. The first dynamic range can be for our values, and the second one is going to be for our apps, right? Because our chart has both values and apps. Both of these ranges need to be made dynamic. So for the first one, I'll just call it my val for values, And for the dynamic range, well, I want to take advantage of the spilling, right, of this hash. So I'm going to go to E3 hash, which is going to take the entire range. So if we just take a look at this, if I click on OK and then I click on this, notice that this area is selected. It's taking the whole range. But I don't want the whole range. Instead, I just want the sales column. So let's go and edit this and then put this inside the index function. That's my whole range. Now in the index function, after we specify the range, we have the row argument. Well, I want to include every single row here, so we can skip that. The next argument in index is the column number. I want the sales column, so that's the second one in this range here, right? So that's it. Now I have a dynamic range that references the sales column. So I'm going to click on OK, and when I click on this, it's only this column. To create the dynamic range for app, that's really easy. I'm just going to copy this, click on new, call it my app, paste the formula here. The only thing I need to change is this, right? I want the first column instead of the second column. Click on OK. Okay, so now I have my app and my val. Click on close. Let's go back to our chart, right mouse click, select data. For the series, click on edit. For series values, here you need to carefully delete the range reference, keep the sheet name. So my sheet is called data, keep that name. And this is going to be my val, and click on OK. Let's go and update the categories as well. So that's the horizontal axis. Click on edit. Carefully delete that last portion where we have the cell referencing and put in my app. Click on OK. And click on OK. Now let's test this. Click on productivity. Do we get everything? Take a look at this. Our range updated. When Cal is there. Click on utility. Our range got smaller. So we created a fully dynamic chart range. Now, as a last step, just to take this one step further, let's also create a dynamic chart title. Now, just like chart ranges, chart titles can't have formulas in them, but you can reference a cell that has a formula. So somewhere to the side of your report, you can already write the function that you need. So we're going to go with equals sales for division. We have to put these in quotation marks. I'm going to put a colon, space, and quotation mark, and I want to combine it with this. But here, I'm going to use the switch function. So since I've already written that out here, let's go and cheat and copy this part of the function. Press escape to leave to this part here. So right after the quotation mark, we're going to connect this with an and add the switch function. Click on enter. We have sales for division game. Now I need to connect this to this. So click on the chart title, then go to the formula bar, type in an equal, and select the cell where you wrote the formula. Now we have a fully dynamic chart title as well. I hope you found this trick useful. Now you can apply this technique to other types of form controls as well, not just radio buttons. Before you leave, hit that thumbs up, subscribe if you aren't subscribed, and I'm going to see you in the next video.